Have you ever heard the expression, if you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all?
I
wish people would listen to that.
Okay. I know, man.
Well, that especially applies to your hair. Yes.
Oh, my God.
In a recent interview with Bustle, grooming guru Jonathan Van Ness of Netflix's Queer Eye reboot, which I love, by the way, says he believes it's important for everyone to compliment their hair. Mm. He says that when you say negative things like, my hair is so fine and thin, I hate you, that bad juju goes directly to your hair.
Whoa.
So instead, Jonathan wants you to hit your hair with a few I love yous each day to give your hair healthy energy, you know? So, ladies, what nice things would you say to your mane?
Well, you know, I have a conversation with my wigs in the morning. Now, this one is Keisha. So, Keisha, please, just, you know, Keisha, just stay right here.
Get it together.
You know, just, that's all. Just stay on my shoulders. You know, make sure that it's on my head right. And Keisha usually listens. Now, you know, Johnny's, that's what the other one is called.
Yeah.
It's the short, blunt one.
Uh-huh.
She does whatever she wants to do. But we're working on it. So I truly do believe that you can talk positivity into your life and into your hair and into your body.
Life.
All of that.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Definitely be positive. I think it's in general. It's not just about your hair. It's about you as a person. If you're, I'm beautiful, I'm strong, I'm smart, I'm this, you gotta tell yourself all types of stuff. And then eventually, you'll believe it and it'll be part of who you are.
So what do you say to your hair?
Listen, as much negative comments as I get on the daily about my hair, because I don't know why people have an issue with it. I love it. I'm fabulous.
Yes. Beautiful.
As much issues that people have, I would say that my hair is bouncy, it's fabulous, it has a whole bunch of personality, and I love it. And whoever doesn't like it, it sounds like a personal problem.
I hear that. I would tell my hair, you know what? As much as I cut you off, you always make it a comeback.
Yeah.
You know, I stay saying I'm gonna let my hair grow and then I end up chopping it off.
Yeah.
So that I would tell her, as much as I fried you, damaged you, somehow you're still hanging on.
Yes.
Because we've done some things to our hair.
Yes.
Especially after all the years of I was blonde.
You're down there, Miss Natural. What do you say to your hair?
I say, you know what? I spent so many years hating you. I love you, and I'm gonna love you forever.
I'm actually
in love with my curls.
Aww.
I love it.
I love it.
We
too.
Asked what compliments you would give your hair, and at Sherland says, thank you for being nappy. We break combs together.
All right. Hey.
We have at Shabin Sarah, who says, dear hair, I hurt you all the time, and sometimes I don't know what to do with you, yet you still stand by me on my important days and try to look the best that you can possibly look, and I'm thankful.
Aww. Crying.
We also have at Nicole Sayoga, girl said, thanks for sticking with me. Even through all the embarrassing cuts middle school brought us.
That's so true.
Off my bangs. I've done some weird things to my hair.
But it's fun to play around with your hair. I think that's pretty cool. Yeah. I mean, that's what it's there for.
It always comes back.
I wrote a letter to my little new wig. Her name is Ling Ling. I love her very much. My letter goes a little something like, hello, showstopper. I appreciate you for helping me on bad hair days and not itching when I sweat. You bring me confidence. You put the nay-nay in my honey. Thank you for looking expensive when I bought you for
$39.99.
Yes! That's right.
I hear that.
I won't apply heat if you don't fall off when I finally get some.
I think when you put a personality to your hair, you have a fun relationship with it no matter where you guys go.
Yeah, up under my wig, my hair is called Esther. For Esther Roll. Yeah, the
What's that? What's Esther Roll?
What's that mean?
Only black people, older black women get what I'm saying.
No, but explain it. I want to learn.
Esther Roll was an actress on the show called Good Times.
Yep.
She had this little teeny weeny afro.
Oh.
But I always admired that. And so that's what I look like. It's a little bit bigger than hers. One day I will wear it.
Yes,
one day I will wear it. One day.
I've been asking you to wear your hair
beautiful,
natural.
Lonnie.
I know.
On you one
well,
time.
Tamera has seen it before.
It's
and,
gorgeous,
you know,
guys. Yeah, and it's a lot longer than what she's
it's
describing.
Beautiful. It's beautiful.
Okay. One day.